In this video, I'm going to try to document as much as possible on how to make a custom subwoofer enclosure. So my sub is going to be placed in the inside corner, and I already cut out a template. So it's going to be like so. Then I'm just going to have another piece of MDF plate on a 90 degree and fiberglass the back side, and then stretch some fleece over from the fiberglass too. So this is everything that I'm going to use for fiberglassing. And of course a mask. And I never fiberglassed before, so this is going to be a new experience. I also have two ovens running because it's pretty cold outside, and you want to have somewhere around 20 degrees to work with when you're working with fiberglass, or at least it's going to go faster than if it would be colder out. The first step is going to be to use tape and tape out all the places that you're going to fiberglass, as well as everything surrounding, so you won't get any on the carpet or in your car. So now everything is taped out, and the next thing to do is just to mark out basically where you're going to fiberglass, and you're basically just going to follow that line and fiberglass everything in. And I'm also going to attach the plate. You may wonder what this piece is for. It's just to strengthen it, because on the back side I just cut out a slot so I can put wires and stuff. So when it's gonna be done, I can put wires underneath it. So now the first coat is finally done. I did a mistake and put in too little hardener. I don't know what I was thinking or not, but I was pretty stupid. So I had to go over and just use a spray ball with some hardener, which is not the best. So I'm just gonna leave this to dry, and hopefully everything will just solve itself. So now I'm gonna apply the second layer, and this time, since I was stupid enough the first time to just fuck everything up, I just measured out everything, or I just used water. So I got 5 deciliters, and here I got measured out 5 or 10 milliliters. I just used a scale and just water, and it was a pretty precise scale, and just measured out 10 grams, which is equals to 10 milliliters of water. So I'm just gonna mix everything back up and just pre-cut some strips so I can put it in there, and you can see I got most of the tape out, and I'm gonna do this. So the second layer is now on, and I think this is gonna be how far I'm gonna get today. And the next step will be to put another layer on and then work on the front plate, which will have the speaker mounted to, then stretch some fleece over. So the fiberglass has now been curing overnight, and it turned out pretty good. A couple of spots, like this one, has got to be filled, and some bubbles that got to be sanded down. So I'm now just going to sand down the places or spots where it's needed, and then prepare for the final layer of fiberglass. The third layer has now cured. I marked out some areas where I want to reinforce, mainly because these are big flat areas with no curves that would strengthen it. So I'm gonna apply a fourth layer, and hopefully this will solve the problem of it flat. The fiberglass is pretty much done right now. I did cut out the curve and sanded it down a little bit, and I also cut out this faceplate. It's gonna be mounted like so, and I'm gonna stretch some fleece over it. But for now, I just cut out this ring, which is gonna be mounted on the back side of this plate. And I'm gonna use a router to cut out this inner hole so that the speaker will stay flush with the MDF plate. And then, of course, this one just will be just glued and nailed down on the back side so the speaker can have something to grab onto. Here we can see a test fit of how everything will look. As you can see, I cut out with a router and then place the other ring on the back side. This is just a loose fit, just to kind of see how things will work out and if I'm satisfied. And I think I'm pretty pleased with it. The box is pretty much done right now. As you can see, I got the resin and this fleece stretch. I think I'll use, I didn't use enough resin because it soaked a lot more than I expected to. But I did trim the edges just on the front and on the back side. So now what I'm gonna do is reinforce it. I'm thinking about just using a filler in small corners like this one, like just on the inside, just do some filler, or just actually just polyester with some small glass balls, and then try to put a small layer of fiberglass on the inside on the bigger areas. It is pretty stiff. You can poke it and move it a little bit, which you don't want, but the rest of the box is just gotten really stiff after this layer has gone on. So let's get the box has now been filled from the inside in every corners, and I've added some dampening materials. I could see the black one, the mat inside. I also added a speaker cable, which is gonna go through the speaker. And instead of using the traditional speaker terminals, I got a small connector which just fit perfectly, and I'll just have the female connector just connect in here, and that will go to the amplifier. So now it's just to put some fabric. The speaker is nearly done. As you can see, I did stretch the fabric over it. I just used a spray glue, and I used spray glue on both the fabric and on the parts that I was going to cover. So it really sticks really well, and it worked out perfectly. So the next thing I'm going to do is fill the inside with polyfill. Just use the same spray glue and fill it with polyfill, and then attach the speaker. It is done, finally! And I'm actually really surprised that it turned out that well. And so now it's just to put in the car, plug in the sub, and try this